προσωπικό του κόμπι, να μου αλέγουν του ράγνα. Και με την δικό μου τσίγμα εγώ του ράγνα, μπήκα. Με ένα τόσο ίδιο και να του ράγνα, μπήκα ράβι. Ένα σχεδιά, μου λένε τσι δικά σε λέγου. Ε, που μου γάμα, που μου κάνω κόμμα να νομίζει τα μάτια να καλού. Μινά μου αλέγουν να μπούκο, να μάτάω του ράγνα. Όλε σίγα μην αγαλικό του ράγνα. Μινά μου αλέγουν να πάω του λέω αμινάκα, που μου γάμα του ράγνα. Ένα μου λένε μάτια που βάλε παγαίμα. Και ένα μάτια που βάλε παγαίμα, είναι σίγα μην αγαλικό. Μινά μου αλέγουν του ράγνα, σίγουρα για να κάνω τσι να πάει TV. Ω, μινά μου αλέγουν να μπούκο, μινά μου αλέγουν του ράγνα. Σε την αγούκο να κάνω καλά και να κάνω καλά του ράγα. Ράνι δίδυ μα και την να μην καλά του ράγα. Με έμα κάστε ρε γάνα ματαμονή. Λόγω είναι ματαμονή. Μην άγω μεγαλέ του ράγα. Πούλε να ματεμβάλε. Ρωτώ που λένε μόνο είναι του ράγα. Μην άγω σε ρε μεγαλέ του ράγα. Ρώσουν να ματεμβάλε. Τα λεσένει τα λοφία του ράγα να ματεμβάλε. Ω του ράγα τσίσου. Μπερσί στα κούλα να ματεμβάλε του ράγα. Βάρο μπαούτ και ο τραγέντρο να καστάει να κλονισεί να ντάει. Brother Elijah Turanga Chisuwa, Nade Gaisani, Makun Rao Turanga Chisuwa, O Daniel Turanga, Bakino, Israel Turanga, and Singa Minamro Joshua, Minamuele, Nivei Buki, Nivei Tokoni, Nivei Maroi, Nivei Marko Kotaki Turanga, and Singa Nai, Masomi Nini Tevoro, Turanga, Tamu Tuba Levi Turanga, Pokota Levi, and the Bukova Minigomi Maroi and Bukau, Unoto Lakuna Malek and the Messi Vit and the Messi Murmura. Μάλλον ένα μπουλά, η μπύρη μπαίτα να κλώ, κάτω από τη βόσα. Η αράγκη και έλεγα με κέμπερ, σε κάμα με τον Ιάνο. Ένα σήμα μην αγαπηκώ να κλώ. Μιλά μου έλεγα με βίντο σάκι, να πάνε με μαλουάι, να βάλε σε κόλλα. Μιλά μου έλεγα με κούνι να μπει μάρο, βίντο σάκι, να βάλε μπουκά. Να λόρι να μότου κάτω του ράνα. Μιλά μου έλεγα του ράνι, κούνι να μπει, ούμιλα και τσιμούνι να μην είναι. Ένα σήμα μην αγαπηκώ. Μιλά μου έλεγα. Μινά μου έλεγα με κούνι να μπει, βγαίνει ένα τεχνικό. Ένα ματάκα μην αγαπηκώ. Αλληλούια. Μινά μου έλεγα τσισού, μινά μου έλεγα. Oh, ni mente ko maki, ni bay maka ko tani. Ano matanga binami si ni ko. Kalau mo turang ani ulo tanga ni masu, masu lang mana turang na mati ni tumi na ko biti. Masu lang mana kaluwe na kami ni siyo na ni ko. Tama ro mana turang na mati ni tumi na ko biti na kami ni siyo ni ko. Paro tumi na biti ni gi na kami ni siyo ni gi. Masu lang mana turang na ni bay kaguni ni bay kai ni gi. Na nasiyo na ni ko sa kilang tondo na nakro. Onde está o meu masula com o meu manua? É na cabine silicoa. Masula que eu nevei no taqui. É na vez sim de mataca. É na silicoa. É na água no lomo de colo. É na cabine silicoa. Masula com a mão turana. Na borroba na colo. É na eu vina congo. Masula na prime minister. Na presidente. É na vez ministers. Masula com a mão na colo. Na oposição liga. Tak boleh buat nak kalau yang kami di sini di kuah. Masuklah kepada nak turana, karena minum tak ini nabi. Ipar masalah lah Yesus. Masuklah kepada nak kalau yang di sini di tay. Tak boleh buat nak kalau yang sana itu di kuah. Karena minum tak ini nabi korokor. Biasana, nabi tikina. Yang kami di kuah. Naya lo yang nonton nak kalau yang kami di sini di tay. Masuklah kau pada turana, kau tu kena rencon, ni mana esok. Masuklah kau pada kau, nak kau binti. Kau turun tu kau main polis, turun tu kau main laki. Enaya aku, kau ni beri lagi. Nak kau mendona, suruh kau, otia. Kau masuk ena, kau beri sini dinai. Kau masuklah kau tu kau pada kau, nak mati itu kena kau binti. Vem morar na rede, na sanção da Caetico. Vem morar na rede, na vaca. É assim que vem, tá? Passou na rua na turrana, não bateu muito bem na rua. Só pra vir na valia, não é nem tudo. Na valia, o turrana, não bateu muito bem. Na valia, o turrana, nem que eu morri na raída, morri na trava, tipo na cala o turrana. Que me sabe, passou na rua, não bateu muito bem, não bateu muito bem. Verda vem do taqui, vem, posso cara, vem cá que vem daquilo, a vereadora que tu rana. E não morri no lugar, não me encrona, leu a aquele cara, assim, a minha cara. Tem que ser uma suraca. Verda vem do taqui, vem com boa. Vem bater de tudo, nem me encrona, tu rana. Vem ministrina, nem me encrona. Tem que ser uma suraca, vem que eu me encrona, tu rana. Vem essa neitina que eu vá. Tem que ser da porra, vem que eu me encrona, tu rana, nem me encrona. Nem é o vim na trombo. Na valeu, tu rana, tu su. Trabalhando nela, tamo. O menino posso ter grande meme que eu outro ano. Que me sabe passar lá na mão do vídeo. E revista o segundo para Cristo na tua. E revista o cancelero do ano. E me sabe na porra bem que é bonito lá na Jesus. E cara, isso é vida. Tu sou gata na cara da minha puta. Ela dá lá que é venado do ano. Lord, we thank you. We receive all the answers of our prayer, having faith and believing in your name. We pray, Lord, in no other name, in Jesus' mighty and wonderful name, we pray, and together we say, Amen, Amen. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Le levan satu kinan dona lebih kira mele mission tu. Amen. Sing na ni kuat.
Amen. Carruana de Tugunala de Singa Vina de Cua, de Tantalangase, e Mosin da Vente de Balo, Zabutuma na Corona e Rugu Metalomau na Itaciri, Cavagatuva full time, Manager Inventory Operation Division, Voa de Tugubera de Tantalangase, Meran da Vente de Balo, Cavabutuma na Corona, Teo da Caldrove, Lubendra Evatico, Cavinga Rabitigo, e a Zona Wanibula, e na Cavinicua. A Babinina, quando a Cloud, a Sucessa da Vana Vuma no Mó, e Metalan Caminada de Casa da Cabana Cloud, que não vamos.
Praise the Lord. Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. First of all, I would like to take this opportunity to thank our Lord Jesus Christ for allowing me to stand on this platform to testify his goodness in my life and my family. Likewise, I would like to thank the Gatsalewu and Aintirai and the family for giving me the opportunity to stand up on their platform built up by God for them, to testify the goodness of this Lord. This God is very wonderful, and this God is so good right till this very moment. I was just sitting down, and then I recall last night I looked at the news through the FBC. I saw the chief operating officer of the FNPF regarding the dividend from the FNPF to the government. And I recall that last week I was sharing with one of the chief executives of a company in the country, and he was telling me that time is coming and time is very hard, especially for us in Tokyo. He told me that even the chief executive officer and the chief operating officer of the Fiji National Provident Fund, the post has been advertised, even though the person that I saw last night has been holding the fort for a few years now. So, like I was sitting there, and I just like to challenge us that wherever you are staying right now, please focus and put all your 100% of your commitment and your resources in this kingdom, because there's nothing good outside this area. As the psalmist said one day in his court is better than 1,000 days outside his court. So I was just thinking along that line, and I want to challenge us, each and every one of us, and those of you who are going to watch through Facebook or live stream, or will view this later, wherever you are, stay rooted in the kingdom of God. Stay put there and put your 100% commitment in these last days to this Lord Jesus Christ. I was sitting down, and I was thinking way back, and I never thought that one day I'll become a full-time doing the work of his kingdom. Just this morning, a colleague of mine from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, he called me and I asked him, what can I do for you? He told me, no, I just want to hear your voice. I just want to say hello to you, Bagayana, to you. Then I told him, okay, I am about to go and do the work of the Lord in his kingdom, in his government, the number one government. And he laughed at me, this gentleman, because when we finish our conversation, I can know the situation they are in. Even though they are riding the government vehicles, even though they are getting salaries fortnightly, even though they are sitting in the office or they are engaging a table with a computer, with a telephone beside them, but it is not like before. It is not like before. So every now and then I used to receive a call from a government official. They just want to hear my voice, and they just want to say, hello, how are you, Bulavinaka? We just want to hear your voice. So this morning I just want to testify the experience I went through when I visited the church denominations and some of the business communities, just trying to market the My TV, and especially the spreading of the gospel around Fiji and abroad. for going through the business communities, some of them, they really appreciate, especially when I am talking to the main boss. They really appreciate and they really stand by of the vision placed in Angasilehu's heart. Especially not much on the my TV, especially because of the new Methodist. But when I look at the church denominations, I told Gasilehu it's easier for me to, while in the government, to liaise with PSS and ministers from other ministries than to liaise with Gasilehu and other Tantangas of other denominations, especially the Pentecostal denomination. So if you are watching this morning or wherever you are, or if you may watch this clip later, I challenge your life. Nowadays, we should take away that boundary, that denomination name. We have to demolish that denomination name, that boundary, and come together and work for the goodness of our good Lord in our country. Wambota ni santren desar tu kumai na nanon da bula wambota ni santren desar tu kumai nan rakye sa tu e matanda e nan ngau na ni kua e sa tu kuna oti tunga ne botan o wali mina tu kuma na kelu na singa na noa kira oti kumai na poda sa au sa to runga da wale uni gosa na gerawa tangga sile una na kaya tu yo na noa au sa to runga da wale uni to wase koya na nona masu masu mai meru kai kotu kore sumai na kelu i black rock mai nanti mengai e warta kawa na bisa na kelu nona sa lutu tiku boyo yo ni tau kei e na tu na ngarra seng na boton. But that yesterday morning was different to me. We were in the Porter's House church, just the three of us. I was sitting there when Gasilehu was testifying. In fact, when we went there, the Pastor John Perry like to divert the meeting to, he just want to hear from Gasilehu. So then Gasilehu, in his elaboration, he gave that testimony. But that very moment was different to me. That the pin dropped silent, that something dropped into my heart that only God knows. When we came out, we had another meeting with the General Secretary of the Fiji Council of Churches. When after that meeting we came out, we take the lead to Lord 3. I was just standing there at my TV, thinking of the experience I went through yesterday at the 8 o'clock meeting. So I believe we are in the last days, and I'm fortunate enough to be chosen by God just to do that little things. Just trying to visit these people, visit the church leaders, visit the business people, just trying to do what God has placed in Gasilehu's heart, for the gospel is the answer to every aspect of our life. So while I was doing that yesterday, I was also thinking of my son who is in Good Victory School. He's supposed to go back on Tuesday, and I was told when I came around on Tuesday to visit some of the companies, one of my former workmates told me, OB, the student at QBS will go back on Wednesday. So while I was walking around in town on Tuesday, a couple called me. They offered me a ride and they asked me, where are you going? I told them I'm going to see a company here at El Tulao. Then when the wife got off, he told the husband, please remember Tantalgas. But at the back of my mind, I told Chope, you wait here, I'll go to do a little bit of work that has been allocated to me, I'll come back, then you'll go in the afternoon to school. I know that Chope, when he enters QBS, he has to pay the $50 boarding fees. And on top of that, I have to provide toiletries for him. But when I told them, when I told him to wait, only God knows what is in my pocket. Then when that lady got off the car, the gentleman drove me around. Instead of taking me to Yatulao, he took me to Flagstaff. He parked the car, I saw him got off, then he asked me, how's Chope? Then I told him, Chope is waiting for me after I finish visiting some of the companies this morning, then I'll go and see him for his trip back to QBS. He got off the car, he went to the ATM, then he came back, he gave me $100. This is for Chope. I was just doing little things for my God. I was just sitting there and I recall While I was about to leave the government, a colleague of mine is also about to leave the government. He resigned the same time as I resigned, and he has been offered a post at the UNDP. He secretly told me the offer, under the offer, the amount that he'll be getting, it's over 100,000 plus. So I was just sitting here, and I recall that that very moment. He may be enjoying that, but I am enjoying more while in his kingdom. In his kingdom, there's no lack in it. That's what the psalmist says in Psalm 23:1. Sana ubi baka tau ko tsobo na siti to rakai na ele biyo. En matakawin na ni singli ko. Awe mbule kina ito na mbula, awe mbule kina ito na matabubali, awe mbule kina ito na taltalangasi, awe mbule kina ito ni taltala. Awe mbule kina ito na luminikal, awe bararomo, awe yaw na matakawin na ni singli ko. So when I came yesterday, I bought a tulipis for Chope. I gave him, this is your $50, and this is your bus fare to QS. You can go by yourself. You are in Form 6 now. He looked at me and he thanked me. I know the only the eyes. Whatever is in his eyes, I know what is there. What he want to say, he told me in his eyes. And I was only thinking about God and nothing else but God. Matawin na nising ni kuwa umbole at ikon doon ang bula, umbole at ikon doon ang tunaturangan, doon ang marama. We get to the HQ staff, the mission boys, mission girls. Nan lako-lako ngo, esana sini bakani, lako-lako toman. Aro mga tiko ni, kadiba tiko masu lagi, tiko nanda papara, tiko na global conference. Only God knows what is there in August. Only God knows. Only God knows. Matawin na nising ni kuwa, Odambuletu kungana ndambula na zabo na kalala ire ndaru zakaba na mate nikalo na zabo na kalala ire ndaru kitaka na nona loma ni mbai ni setigo bike ndaru na kokowa setigo ne vego ni mbula setigo na vana na ndaru se atra zake mai se ndaru rai rao tikuru mataka bina ni singi kuwa. Do your best to the Lord, because we never know when will be our day. I believe I was allocated to go and do the burial ceremony in Makwe zone on Saturday. And even till yesterday, they remind me. Say, "Tigo ngabo na numu na numu yao we waro tega in the summer." Say, "Tigo ngabo imokoi." Amen. We yao say, "Bibi tunga yao me zaka tunga na zaka niklo kina kala lekeve dona kai sulibi ona kalo na dondo wao zuruma tukina na nonra bi walivola na mboso lele univi kampani kina gasi lele univi songo sabulot. Siyang serengai ni bauto suka imuri walilai se. Se o lomo lomo rua na ngono da kabatu kina na kaza ngo ene ka ene ya sigle buna sigle ko bale da nuclear tigo ni dona ngono na lava mai dona ngono na oti mai na ngo bila mai dona ngono na se di duri tali ke bona do wasi atu na bina ka ba sigle buna sigle ko a do taun ka garo ni tunga na nona tigo na na bakaro roko nona tigo na lang lang nona tigo na bakan ele sigle buna sigle.
Hallelujah. Can you all put our hands together? This afternoon, the Bible says, the book of Proverbs 19:21, there are many plans in a man's heart, only God's plan will be prevailed. Hebrews 11:14, for God has planned something better for us. Only together with us, the plan will be made perfect. Their testimony this afternoon, the last, Senior Pastor Siliasi Takayawa, hails from Natokalau, Matukulau, works as a head of campus, Monolevu area, zone, as our senior pastor in Wairiki in Lambasa. Just give a big hand to the Lord as you welcome him this afternoon.
Praise the Lord. Nandun sa Mekka, ito na narusukul gabito, kaya kaisang ni Tarana wali kutsoba, sa awad wali kuri sa Tarana, kaya kaisang ni Bukatawa, na kuru kutsoba, yan wali ni Bukatawa. I would like to stand here and testify the goodness of his Lord in my life. Hallelujah. And my family. It's not that easy for me to make a choice to join New Methodist. Amen. By that time, my relatives heard and saw a DVD in regards to our Ngaselebu, and majority of them, maybe they don't like the way he preached. But for me, it's totally different. The decision that I made on that day, that is a morning, a Saturday morning, it's a decision which I never regret in my life. Even though I'm the youngest in the family of eight siblings in the family, and we are all men, we are all male. We don't have any sisters. for their further studies. And when I passed my class 8, I just came and stay with the elders in the family, with his family. So when I grew up, I just feel a love and care amongst them towards me because I'm the youngest in the family. Amen. And this point in time, my decision that I made to be a member of New Methodist Christian Fellowship, they seems to push me aside. And that is make me a man enough in the things that I do, and I always praise God. I thank God that's the level now I live. And when you go with Jesus, when you go to the gospel, you know, go with Jesus. Seven in Rawa, oh, I've been in the town, and I know the two of them. Then I'm going to see many times people ridicule and swear and curse about their family. But today we see and we reap a fruit of family of only six started all the ways from Malawi in India. We are now going to chicken go mo kind of nagani turang. Several times my married life from the year I've saved from the ministry through his DVD. Rendini always heard a lot of swearing words. I chased her several times from my family and I said, you go. We can just share the children. That is not that difficult for me because I know I'm working and you are working too. You can look after yourself, I can look after mine. And that's the kind of attitude that I have. The word of God that I heard from the New Methodist really changed my way of life. Who I am now. Amen. Why are you going to be able to do that? But when I'm going to be able my further studies does not even change anything on me. E vou cair em bicho ou sou cuchuma, que não dou no logo chukin. Pete sinto na cabeça. Na mano rongo de kinana você ni go, e piso ta na ngumula. E o que eu vou dona tama ta bina, de tu ta que nendila. E vou ni lo tichu. Mandongo I was in Nandi, on the campus in Nandi. I observed the movement of the students in Nandi. Some of them came to school with three quarters. Some of them came to school with long, long beard. The hair is not cut. For me, that is not on. Because I have been taught in the ministry, very disciplined ministry, even start from me. Amen. Why are we believing in the Bible? Because maru tanga kina naturanga. Bila naba na nugu pulo wayau kipa kawa wayau tunga. Bila tanyu tamata yalo koko, tamata yalo thao, tamata yalo lep. Amen. Kewa sanga ni wayau tunga. Amen. Nanong ko pagay yung chico with Jesus, aw sarap na kaya na kapa na kalaw. Malay ta na, natamatama ta na yung gay, in my na campus, e na puno obi nito kichokin, sakinda mo na kaya dun dun me, kakuni laka, na kaya dun dun me. Amen. Niu, tumbali na korito, endo e sena ni na kapa na kalaw, tuko na biko me taka, o kaya na puni tegeo, e na kaya sing ni dun dun me. Kaya ang mga binibina kataka kini na turang abiwakani, for those of you two will be watching live from the life feed that we have today, it's really challenged me. Why? Because I'm not that good. Amen. Na bosan ni ko, pero tanda ng nanong gumulo mo bundo tu naka. Ano bukod niyan ng bigkadim na kalo? Bago niyan ng tanda turang, bukod niyan ng bintalay, bukod niyan ng bigkadim. Amen. Oh, kilati ko na non rosa ka orong kasi lang bilang mo tatal ng gaste sa loob mo isuba. Amen. Pero sa mga magalak na nanong glesi, kuno niya. Amen. Aubya tukunya utanggo mleta indotan nga kadini ko. Amen. For us here in Vitelevu, Ponole is quite a challenging place. The place is not that near. Amen. Dito tumi koroko na mando sa oti. Halilo, koroko bebe lakong ko isi ngatokan ngay. Duru talo lo manibunuwa. Amen. Nakiya na yan. Iula beto roko na kalaw. Mleta na chikino tunloa. Amen. Nakari ni nakaw na kalaw. Kina nontambulan ni nabagayo binis. Last year, our Gaselevo was on a charity drive after Winston. Nawaini was one of the villages that they declined to hear the word of God. Just last week, Commissioner Northern called me and told me, can you accompany my team? I said, where to? To Nawaini village. And can you go and address the elders at the Nawaini village? Amen. Meli kena kikibir na kaya binakata na madet to membelete na itubutu binibuli. Osa, to the way to Nawaini, amen. Ang mga regalesyon ni bayan na ibang sawat ira ba kaulay na namos ni kalu. Beta ka niyula ko chukay na matin tu pinkarabi chuko na ngong nungo. Amen. Kaya rato ka tukin na tamat. Kaya sarang may challenge na gikin na New Methodist ko. I just want to challenge us. Whatever we value or treasure in life, that is determined our destination tomorrow. Amen. Ang may rin ito niyo, to the kitura, pakarorong ito na ito niyo, isang talento na kaya kari. Amen. Ang matang usang isi-usang wigyan. Beto niyo, pati mo ni Timia, Hallelujah. Ito mo na lang mo, na isulat na gilamay, mo kaya kari bihira, na kango ito ng mga, na bukuni mo, buli ito rin. Meron ito meri kina, na lubi bichin ni kuwa, na bukuni mo, kaya palit na nanon ng buli. I am not a teacher, it's a profession. But now, yes, I am. I am a mechanic, it's a profession. Amen. E um bom mecânico. Ou seja, ele vai investir em mim. Preza lá, né? E eu vou abrir a minha tela na turma, na perna lá. Ou seja, se eu não ganho mecânico, ou seja, se eu não ganho investir em mim. Não, não, não. Ou seja, põe tudo em clou. Perna lá, porque tu tá aqui na vida. Não, não, não. Não, não, não. Não, não, não. Não, não, não. Amen. Now, during our difficult time, we know, we knew where to do. Myself and Redeem. Before, no, Redeem go outside. Amen. Stand na kaki ko muli. Amen. Hallelujah. The big Galileo we won't get the cup and the glow. You don't know what you mean. You don't know what you mean. You don't need to mark. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, come in the middle of the town. You can. Hallelujah. Little weekend, the bottom better and better. The car that comes to the glow, the Roman mission go. Hallelujah. You have a minute of the glow. Bring it up. The big guy, the car will go here. Who's surrounded in the Nanaka? Who's surrounded in the Nanangi? And the big Galileo we won't get. Pero tayo siguro kinakulong mga hangi. E nila ko lang. Pagkakit na pagkakit na kukwad. E nila ko tao siya siya ngayon. Kukwad, siya talibig ko. Nalangin
lang. Pagkakit na pagkakit na pagkakit. You know, my came to the Lord. Jeremiah 1:12. Bible says, I will watch over my word until my word come to pass. When my word is sent forth, it won't return void. Exactly when it's set forth, before it gets sent to the Lord. Praise the Lord. Kaya naman tabulo na talaga mo sa nasigil talalala. E na taga-taga man naman namin pagkaya talagina.
Na tua vela, vem na tua vela, vem na tua vela, Jesus. Yeah.
Father, that your presence brings peace, the authority, the power, the provision in this place. We thank you, Father, that we can come and fellowship, especially to hear the teaching today. Thank you that you will speak to us, O Lord. Your power in your word will bring life to somebody here and those that are tuning in live wherever they are, in their workplace, in their home, in their vehicle, or overseas. We praise you. We acknowledge your name. We thank you, Father, for the opportunity to come together, the opportunity to continue to listen to your word. And we give you the glory, the honor, and the praises to be yours and yours alone. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray, and all the saints shout.
Amen.
All the saints shout.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Bless the person next to you, and you can take your seat in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Take this time to welcome you all in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I believe that we will be blessed again today with the Bible study. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Tantala Sami. Hallelujah. For continuing, allowing us to come and use this facility.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let us give a mighty hand clap to Tantala Sami. Amen. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. We are living in an era right now that our life is challenged.
Hallelujah.
Whether you work as a government worker, work in the company, regardless of the level, regardless of the degree, regardless of achievement, the time now, we are challenged in every angle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even the company in all nations, they are looking, what's the answer?
Hallelujah.
They are looking. There's a lot of meeting everywhere in the world. What is the problem of this? What is the solution for this problem? What is the solution for this problem? Again, another problem here. What is the solution for this problem?
Many.
Amen. But nobody is turning it to God.
Hallelujah.
Everybody is searching for the answer.
Many.
But there seems like there is no answer. Well, there is some answers, but the answer is only for a short time. It's like a band-aid.
Many.
Eh? Plaster. It's not like a stitch, but it's like a plaster. Just there, when you go and have your bath, and the plaster will go off from where it's supposed to be. Amen.
Amen.
The whole world. Hallelujah. In every areas, husband and wife, a family, the parents and the relationship with their children, the neighbors in the workplace, and the problem continue to happen and escalate. Sangay toro lagi tibo nga ng toro soko. Hallelujah. And people are running everywhere looking for the solution. When God said in Psalm 127, if God does not build a house, then the builder will work in vain. Kesa si itarana malo ko tsoba. Kung ito natarabaliti ko, era na otan namay. That's exactly what is happening today. I was really blessed last week, week before last week, and this week again. I was interviewing some senior pastors. And most of them, they go through university. Most of them, they have degrees. And when you hear the testimony, you know, most of the time, we hear the testimony on a church environment, just that gap, just that 10 minutes change. But when you hear the testimonies of where they grow up, primary school, secondary school, it's all in the Facebook. If you go to the Souls to Jesus page, you go there. There's a lot of testimonies of our senior pastors. Hallelujah. And you will appreciate what God is doing. And sometimes we don't know. Hallelujah. Take for example, the vice president of Ratu Sukuna Memorial School. Just take for example. Hallelujah. When he was testifying, this young boy from Lebuka, in the beginning of Lakemba, in Tesanolau. Hallelujah. He started to grow up. Primary school, secondary school, and end up in university. First years from, even though he was a bright student in his secondary school. And I was trying to listen to his testimony. The same thing that I faced in 1981 in university, the same thing that he faced. Hallelujah. And then, Tatanga Simosi from Wayimula. Testify again, the same thing that I face, BP face, and he face. When young people, they are flourished with their education level from secondary school, but when they come to an environment of freedom, in university, freedom, hallelujah. And first year, or sometimes not even the second year, they flop.
Hallelujah.
Why? They go to church. It does not happen to other races. It only happens mostly to Fijian and Pacific Islanders.
Many.
The university is like a place that the freedom is too much that they don't concentrate on their schoolwork and they start to concentrate on other things. And they were mentioning peer pressure. So I asked them one by one, what is peer pressure? Peer pressure is a package of alcohol, girls, nightclub, singing, drinking,
hallelujah,
and nightlife. Just go to town.
Many.
Instead of studying in school, they're just coming to town. Oh, we're schooling at university.
Hallelujah.
Most of them, they don't make it the first time. They have to go and find a work, and then they come again because they have a talent of praying, but they cannot utilize their time. So, our brain cannot fix the problem.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We can be well educated, we can receive or attain degrees or master degree for that matter, but the answer is not in there. The answer is with the one who created everything.
Hallelujah.
I was looking at the weather report. The Fiji is right in the middle. To the northwest, we have Dona. And to the northeast, we have Ella. And both of them, like they are moving towards. One is moving to the south, and one is coming from the north. Remember the three things that God uses to speak to a nation when we don't listen to His word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So the weather pattern that is going on like this, it's signifies, is trying to tell us that there is a creator that wants us to do something.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And the two countries that we bombarded with cyclone, one is Vanuatu and one is Fiji. Nearly 3 years in a row now. Hallelujah. Why? I believe that that somehow the people are not humbling to God. We are just so busy with the things of this world that we are not humble to hear from God.
Amen.
Amen. On Monday morning, he called me. He said, we will not be live streaming at the moment because Dona is coming to Vanuatu and is coming at category 5. I said, it's okay. Just tell the church members, nobody should move around, secure their place. And just wait. Make sure you pray that the donor will not come in and damage your country.
Many.
Hallelujah. And suddenly, donor didn't turn around. If you see, donor just come to Vanuatu and turn around. Instead of reaching to Vanuatu, he turned around. Hit Caledonia and now he's going a little bit south. South, a little bit south, southeast. That means bending towards Fiji.
Many.
And they say that it's weakening. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Those are signs. The Bible says those are the signs that we are not listening to God's word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Why people, when God created everything, and if anything wrong with anything, we turn to man, we turn to organization, we turn to NGOs, we turn to government, we turn to Nebuchadnezzar, we turn to Caesars. But God created everything. Why can't we turn to God?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. To me, it's the most stupid things in the world. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, where are you turning to? Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's very simple. It's very, very simple. This is not part and parcel of the Bible study. But I've just been burdened to challenge us today. Wherever you are, whatever you're facing, hallelujah, that you really need to trust in God.
Amen.
I trust in God.
Amen.
Amen. When we went to the potter's house yesterday, we were just explaining about my TV and the platform that God can use to deliver the word of God. And in the middle of my sharing, hallelujah, and I start to testify. And if up to me, I will not be doing what I'm doing today.
Many.
Hallelujah. If it's up to me, I will not resign from my job.
Hallelujah.
I'll be sitting, grabbing my job, sitting at the 50 grand a year. Oh, that's wonderful.
Many.
Not only that, with the privilege, traveling around the world. Hallelujah. Only paying 10% of a fare. Unlimited.
Many.
Amen. If I want to go to Australia, $100.
Hallelujah.
Because of the 1,000. If I want to go to America, I'll pay $300. That's if I pay.
Amen.
But if we go on the FOC, I just pay tax, which is about maybe $120 or $130 a tax.
Amen.
The ticket, the food is free. Why should I come and preach in the street of Suva, preach in Harbor Center, preach in Losari, when I own a good job?
Amen.
You know why? I start to realize that when you work for God, there is a peace that you cannot explain.
Hallelujah.
The peace that the money cannot give.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's good to have money here. Yeah. Don't take me wrong. It's good to have money. It's good to work. Hallelujah. And not only that, in 2004, as I testified so many times, I was offered 150,000. My work is 50,000 times 3, 150,000. 150 divided by 12. How much is that? So 120, 12 months, say 10,000 times 12, that's 120. So a little bit, so 30,000 is still left. So 30 divided by 12, nearly comes to 3,000. So that 3,000 plus 10. So round about 12,500 in a month. And they were calculating, 12,500, see? 12,500 a month, they are making we sell. Amen. And God said, because he showed me that bottomless pit, and I see Kaimiti going to the bottomless pit, and everybody knows the Bible, knows well, what is the bottomless pit?
Hallelujah.
If you know the Bible, you know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
So when we were in Marriott last week, Marriott Hotel in Mommy, God reminded me when I was standing in the Maka, that's where the beginning of that lake that God formed from Mommy right up to Lautoka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And God wants to show me that the church that we are doing does not take us to heaven. Because God showed me that people, they are falling in the bottomless pit, they are wearing sulumulamula, Suru Magatanga, necktie. And that is the church clothes. See what I mean? So why God show me the church clothes?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So when I was crying in my vision. Then I heard a voice. I don't see anybody. I haven't heard God's voice. But I feel in my spirit God was speaking to me. Your tears will never say
a single soul that is falling there. If you love them, don't accept the offer tomorrow. Don't sign the contract tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
Go back to Fiji. Preach in villages, preach in cities and towns, preach in schools, in parks, in government, in companies.
Hallelujah.
Don't worry, I will put my word into your mouth. That's why I'm not worried about preaching. I worry about Bible study.
Hallelujah.
I prepare Bible study, but preaching, I don't worry about preaching. Because I start to realize, whenever I will stand up and preach, God is always true to His word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So we must take, you know, the testimony that we heard this morning. Three testimonies. We must take the testimonies very seriously, because those are the fruit of the God that we are serving.
Amen.
And maybe sometimes we take it lightly, or maybe it's just a program of the church. No. The testimony is the fruit. Just like mango, have a fruit. The mango fruit, that mango tree will not be liked by the people if not bears the fruit. Until that mango tree bears the fruit, everybody loves the mango tree. Because of the fruit. Amen. So nobody likes the breadfruit tea. If there's breadfruit tea, does not have the breadfruit.
Hallelujah.
So we must have fruit. That's why we have the testimonies. Amen. So when you come and worship God, I always challenge us.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, when you come and serve God, don't bring your laziness. Don't bring you that you are bored. Hallelujah. You don't look like that when you go and watch the game. You don't look like that when you, there's a party in the family. No, everybody excited. Your big earring is pulling your ears. Amen. But you don't mind, because you are enjoying where you're going. Same as you come to church. Whether it's human, whether it's hot, whether it's cold, whether there's no air condition, there's no fan, you mustn't be excited, because the presence of God is here. How do I know the presence of God is here? The Bible says, when two or three gathered in His name, He's here. And when He's here, some is saying, one day here is better than 1,000 days in groups with them. Hallelujah. High five to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, you are in the right place. Get excited when you come to do the things of God. Amen. So when you get excited to do the things of God, everything that you do will be always positive. Amen. Because you are excited. The singing, the keyboard, those camera people, the media people, everybody, when you come and get excited, the spirit of excitement will be in the church. Hallelujah. Nowadays, when we go to church, it's like a funeral service going on. Praise the Lord. No, it's not a funeral service. It's a resurrection service. We are getting excited because God can do something. Do you know that God can do anything of anything on anything with anything? Do anything? That's what God can do. He just wants to surrender our life. Amen. I never knew that I will be like this one day. I just a lay preacher in the Methodist Church. I get excited to sing for God. I get excited to be part of God. Because He's a good God. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I see your face, I know the God that you serve. Just by your face. Amen. many, because of my, when you go, look to yourself into the mirror, smile at the mirror, you tap your forehead, you do your feet. So make sure you come here, you are ready to serve God. Hallelujah. Am I talking to someone? Because see, the excitement will open the door for God to work in your life. Some of us sitting here, we need some miracle in our life. Huh? Some of us, we sit here, we need some money into our account. Some of us. I believe some of us, we here, we want our children to excel. Maybe there's some pain or maybe some sickness in our body. We want that sickness to go away. Amen. And that sickness can go away because we are serving a God who performs miracles. And then is the name that was given to him. His name is Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. And then is the God that we are serving. So when we come, get ready. Your basket, your spiritual basket must be open. Amen. Your spiritual memory bank must be open. So when you finish from here, you go home with a lot of spiritual food to feed you and raise you to another level. Hey, I'm talking to someone here. And there is a God that we are serving. He's not a God sitting in the minor and the bull will come and land on them. No, our God can walk, our God can talk, our God can heal, our God can see, and our God can hear. And that is the God that we serve. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sorry, we're not going to close, really. Okay. That's a good introduction, Pastor. Amen. Praise the Lord. Nearly all to call again before I start the lesson. These are the 7 guidelines to spiritual growth, and I will go to number 6. I believe Dr. Lagaste was brushing up again on number 1 to number 4. Week before last week, I was talking about the good or the right fellowship. Fellowship with right people. Say with me, right people.
Right people.
Yo, Calvinico Fellowship of Italia. As a child of the Most High God, you supposed to mingle and share and tell Noah, baby Kanye, with the people that they have the same mind. Hallelujah. If you go down to a level of people, they are drunkard, people that they are in the world, you are going there to minister. You are not going there to fellowship. You are going to minister. You go call to Vera, you go le buetira, and pull them and call them, invite them to come to you. You don't fellowship with grog drinkers and grog swipers. And many. Amen. You don't fellowship with pub crawlers and adulterers.
Oh.
No, you minister to them. Amen. 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 Fellowship with the right people. That was number 5. I'm talking about if you want to grow in the spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Tombale matagira na leone. Amen. Tanda matagira na pera.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Tanda matagira na teka. Que go vina kata me tumbu no mumbu lo mgao. Que una logo matagira na tomate ni kona tomate. Logo matagira na tomia leo kona puki mando ya leo. Logo matagira na leo kona puki mongka uri pufta kasi. Amen. Fellowship with the right people. Amen. And when we fellowship, we are not guarding our spirit. So we are rubbing off to one another. And sometimes you come back from a wrong fellowship, and then you come home, you start to fight with your wife, you fight with your husband, you fight with your children, because you fellowship with the wrong people. And the wrong spirit jump on you. So you are coming home with the wrong spirit. There are so many evil spirits. Eh? We don't see them, but they are there. Just like you breathe the air, you cannot see the air. But you know the air goes to your lungs, waiting for your blood to come across. and the air, the oxygen in your lungs, oxygenated your blood before it goes back to your heart. And from your heart and pushed to the other parts of the world, of your mind, of your body, of your legs, and your hand. Amen. Amen. But nobody see the air that we breathe. And when you breathe the air, there are so many divided type of air. We call it nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. There are so many, about 10, 9 or 10 different kind of air goes through your nose. And your lungs have the filter, just like to filter the tea. That's how God created you. Because they move to Ganalangi, Kenabi Matagal, Koyawa, Hallelujah. Koyawinak, Koyawin Sidikau, Imatagalitan, Boy the Pitch in Tokaruda, Boy Gotani, Kotiko in Dinamati, Boy Nundru. All those air that you breathe, Sakale filter taki. Breathe taki maitu mo kwa sinya ngeloma.
Hallelujah.
That's why when you wake up in the morning, you open the door. There's like a fresh air outside. Why? Because the plant breathe out oxygen and they take in carbon dioxide. While you as a family at home, all the opening are closed, Sakale circulate iloma na lama. Carbon dioxide. So the air, you can feel, you can taste its pain. That's why when you open in the morning, you open the door, you just feel the fresh air. It's not a new air, it's just fresh. Because the plants around you, they just take in what's your rubbish, and they put out what's their rubbish. So the rubbish to the plant becomes useful to you. The rubbish of you becomes useful to the plant. That's why when you grow a lot of grass, you feel when you are under the mango tree, the shade under the plants or the tree is different of the shade of a just a shed. You'll feel different. And then you can it's not an air freshener. Amen. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you have a freshener. We have a fresh air freshener, which is the Holy Spirit. So when the Holy Spirit is with you, He suck out all the thing, the dirtiness in you, and produce you the things that are useful to you. All those systems are godly systems. Amen. And created by God and God alone. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So be careful when you fellowship with the wrong people. You must fellowship with the right people.
Amen.
Now, number six. Second last. Godly living. We are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I'm not perfect. It does not mean that our God is full of love and mercy and grace for us to continue to sin. Oh, na kalundo lolo mani to kalu. Sige tamo nga ang confess. Only on Sunday, then I'll run to the altar. That's how we look at this God. From Monday to Saturday, we do everything from the bottom of the Red Sea right to the top of Himalaya Mountain. We touch everything that is dirty. Only on Sunday, we come to the altar to run and give us a prayer. Monday, you start again. No, we're not supposed to abuse the love of God in our life. We're supposed to try to live a holy life because the God that we serve is a holy God.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen?
Let us read 1 Peter chapter 1, 13 to 16. Can you read with me?
Amen.
2, 3. Therefore, gird up the loins of your mind. Be sober. And rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As obedient children, not conforming yourself to the former lusts, as in your ignorance, but as He who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct, because it is written, be holy, for I am holy. God demands us to be holy, even though we are not perfect. You struggling? Yes. You fall, yes, but try to live a holy life.
Amen.
Because we are set aside. We are peculiar people. we are set aside by God. We are not a normal person when we surrender our life to Jesus Christ. We become a temple of God. You are the temple of God. This is the church. This is Akafo. This is a place of worship. It's not the house of God. You are the house of God. When you walk around, you are walking around as a house of God. So the things that you say, the things that you do, you must like a house of God. I'm really sorry for the Fiji, for the Itoke, the Christian in Fiji today. We are not taught that we are the temple of God. Is it the Mahamuli? Can the Kemi see the Roma is a limit? Is it the Mahamuli? No, can the Navalinikalu? As long as we can perform some acting in the church, after the church service, we go back to the world. Namosamo Sadana, Mother Italia. Amen. And that's not how God wants you and me to live this life. Amen. The Bible says, gird up the loins of your mind. You know, most of the time when we come to the church, like we don't want to train our mind. We don't want to know the things of God. We just come to church like just lift up your hand. And you go with feelings.
Many.
You go with feelings and especially for us Pentecostal. And there is anointing will come. But we don't want to train ourselves to exercise the word into our mind. When the killer was cynical. Amen. When you know the word of God, then the word of God in your mind will remind your heart.
Hallelujah.
When we don't have the word of God, that's why it's very easy to sleep along the way.
Hallelujah.
Because we don't know the word of God.
Yes.
We were not taught to memorize the word of God.
Hallelujah.
We were not taught that the word of God that can be carried to the workplace, that can you can take your Bible to the workplace. We were not taught of that. That's why when sometimes when we say to pray in our workplace, some people say, hey, leave your church in your church. Don't bring your church here.
Amen.
You've heard those. Don't wrong about it. No, that is the devil speaking.
Amen.
Our God is Shama. That means he's everywhere. Hallelujah. He's not a God in the church. He's not a God in the village.
Oh.
He's a God of everywhere. His name is Shama. When you walk in coming street, when you walk down Mark Street, when you're in the bus stand, or when you in the bus, and I say bus, even in the worldly music booming away, remember, God is there.
Hallelujah.
And watching all the Christians, they're tapping along with the world music.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Because we were not taught. And I believe now we start to hear message. We start to hear the message that is coming out. Not only in the live feed, Facebook, but also in the television, in the radio. We tend to leave God in the church and we go and Pakabitalia, Pagelawa. And on Sunday we meet God again there. No, he's not a God like that. His name is Shama, Emmanuel. That's why sometimes the church people, we struggle. Because we don't want to involve God in our day-to-day living. When we're stuck, call his name. When you have no money, call his name. When you have a problem with your wife or with your relative, call his name. Because he's a God that is everywhere. That's why they call him Jehovah Shama. Because his presence everywhere. When we are sitting here in Ark of Hope, here in Stewart Street in Suva, his presence in MHCC, his presence in Tapusi. He's not a God only in September Church, Balevatu. No.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can you put up a nature of Ira, Era, Satyo. That's why it's a challenge today for Christians today. Wherever we go, that we are the salt. We are the salt of the world. We are the light of the world. We are not a light in the church. In the church we look nice because of our clothes. But only God knows what's behind that white dresses and white shirt and necktie. You know, we used to be like that. I used to be like that. To the pile everything there because they will stay there for a while. Ah, hallelujah. Santo mother, he goes, I have read this as he also. Sakabrene Rua. He said, I don't want to go to Santana. No, no, pull it to my baby. Hallelujah. Pour lui quand tu vas savoir comment il va qu'il a la carte là. Amen. But the Bible says that we must live a holy life. The Bible says.
Amen.
Not that Tatala, not for me to say, no. I'm just sharing what the Bible says. That we must be holy because the God that we serve is a holy God.
Amen.
And most of us, all of us, we will not achieve 100%. But God wants to see whether you are trying or not.
Hallelujah.
He looks at the desire.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay. The holiness must be to your body. Three things. Eh? Your soul, your mind, and your body. I will talk on your body. My will come together. 1 Corinthians 3, 16, 17. Ruotol. Don't you know that yourself are God's temple and that God's spirit lives in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him, for God's temple is kept. And you are the temple.
Hallelujah.
That's why wherever you are, there are positive things happen because you are the temple of God and the presence of God is with you. That's why when they take Jonah and throw Jonah to the sea, hallelujah, he was with God because God called him to go to Nineveh. So the presence of God was with him. Hallelujah. So when the cyclone came and disturbed all the waters and the wind, so it is a stepping stone. So it is a method that God used. See, God used a cyclone. God uses weather pattern to tell us that something we need to do or to be done.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Don't you know that yourself in God's temple? Amen. Every Christian and every person, we must know that we are the temple of God.
Amen.
And imagine everything that you do, everywhere that you go, everything that you say, this God is listening and watching.
Hallelujah.
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 That's why David said to Solomon, Solomon, my son, you need to know your father's God. Because when you know that your God is with you, you will change the way that you live your life.
Hallelujah.
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 So the reverence of God in your life, or the level of God, will be different. Ningono ko kila kina ni sabatiko si ko magi kaya sabatiko na bisyo. Sabi mi na natural. I don't know how much more I can try to do that. That you must know the God that you serve. My First Corinthians, I don't know we are talking to what they call the First Corinthians 6, but again, the First Corinthians 3. I don't know we are talking to what they call. Go on a 6 go. 19:20, na 3, na 16:17. My, look my, wrote on. Don't you know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. Amen. God is reminding us you are not your own.
Amen.
Digo, sega ni nomu. So don't do anything to what is not yours. Hallelujah. Because you are not owned by you. You are owned by God. You come from God. You live here for God. And after this life, you'll go back to God. Am I talking to someone? Yeah. The Bible says, don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? In chapter 3, it was talking about, don't you know that you are the temple of God? Another step. Don't you know that the Spirit of God lives in you? Hallelujah. Remember the God in one. The Bible is not wrong, or the Bible is wrong. We are the temple of God. That means God that we serve, the God, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit lives in us. He lives in us. Hallelujah. Don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you? He's not living outside of you. He's living in you. You are created to be the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. What's happening in you, in your body, your mind, your words, what you share, what you hear, the Holy Spirit knows. And sometimes we ask for blessings, but the Holy Spirit cannot open the door to blessings because we are entertaining a lot of things that are not of God. The Bible says, don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you? He resides in you. He lives in you. Whether you go to church or not, whether you belong to a denomination or not, you are created to be the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. If only people know that they are the temple of the Holy Spirit, when the people know that the police are watching, if the people know, man knows that their wife are watching, they will not play around. If the wife knows that their husband are watching, they will not argue piche only muri. Amen. Because you know that they are present. When we know that our God lives in us, we will not do or not even desire to do to come away from God's standard and God's calling. Because we know that He is there. Hallelujah. When you give excuses not to go to your worship center on Wednesday, last night, God knows. Amen. And the same God that you are lying to, and the same God you are asking for provision, open doors, provide the way, the same God who sees the nitty gritty in the balls and nuts of your life, the same God that we are asking. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible says, the things you do in the secret will one day will be put on the rooftop. Why? Because everything on the rooftop now, that's what you normally does in the secret. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What's on your rooftop now? Amen. You know, we only think of something on the rooftop is something bad. Also something good. Amen. In the secret place, whether it's good or whether it's bad. The Bible says, everything done in the secret will be put on the rooftop. Amen. Amen. Whether it's good or whether it's bad. Some people, they are famous today because they do their road run, their exercise, they go to the gym in the secret time, nobody knows. Hallelujah. Some people, they show off during the team run and the time of the game, but they are not faithful in the secret place. God only put to the rooftop what's happening in the secret place. Hallelujah. I believe you have this what is on the rooftop now. That's what has in the secret place put on. Snap here and there. I remember starting Nandi. Whenever there's a meeting, they don't want to involve New Methodist. They come to Suva, there's a lot of meeting. They always want to snap New Methodist. What's happening now? Every day, five times a day.
on the television. Every morning, Katalawana. Every Sunday, Bulay FM. Why? What they try to snub.
Hallelujah.
And what was happening in the secret place, God placed it on the rooftop. The Bible says, God will place it on the rooftop for what? For what? Itu lucu kau tak? Nak keluar negara ini dan jadi malam ni apa? Merah rai dan nak mati kena. Hallelujah. You want something good on the rooftop?
Yeah,
yeah, go to the secret place now.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Kau kini kau terasa apa? Kau kini kau terasa rooftop. Ia langsung kau kini kau terasa apa? Go down to the deep end. Go down to the secret place. Dwell in the secret place. The Bible says, those who dwell in the secret place. Hallelujah. What the Bible says? They will be abide by the shadow of Almighty. Amen. Because the secret place, that's where God, only God works. Nobody else knows the secret place, only God. You can be doing something in the secret. Maybe something good, or maybe something that is not good. But I tell you, sooner or later, will be transmitted from the rooftop. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Who is in you? Whom you have received from God? See, this spirit comes directly from God.
Hallelujah.
Say to me, from God.
From God.
Okay. This some of you will be asking. Maybe some of you on the television, some of you on the Facebook live. When was the spirit comes into my body? When? Remember the Psalm 139? Amen.
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 You remember Jeremiah chapter 1? 1 to 5?
Amen.
Amen. Before you become somebody,
hallelujah,
God already knew you. Kembali na nauna, yako kina na pila doon. Sa kreta kito na tamata. Yeah, no, that's when enter. So meron niyo kukuni ko nitaki. Eh, before you are conceived. Kaya ba, so meron niyo biya doon, kukutaki na. God knew you. That means we are in the mind of God. I just, thank you, Holy Spirit. I just have this picture. There's a lot of spirit in God. And when God wants to send His spirit to somebody, it comes from the mind of the mind of God, the nuclear of God.
Hallelujah.
Before you even conceive, I knew you. Before you were born, I call you. Kembali ni ko sekila ini pernah ni ko seperni rombiado ni ko takina ini sakit itu mana kau? Amen. Mau nak usut tu mungkin lah sakit kedemi ko nak. So you are originally from God. Into the womb, when you become the in the process of that conceive, enter. He is from the beginning of you. Not because you go to class one, not because you join the church, no. He was there. The spirit you receive from God, whom you receive from God. Hallelujah. So everybody that lives in this planet, we have a spirit of God in us. That's why there is always a conviction of any godly behavior or any ungodly behavior. There is a conviction. Oh, the composition. Who is telling you? Dizal mo pamatendo na tamata. Kung di kami ko dizal mo pamatendo na tamata, ikaw mo pamatendo naman naman. Ikaw na nibirikan doon, beka nito gramat. Ikaw na nipanahan doon na ikaw. Ang ikaw mula, ang beka mula, tamate mula. Kung di ka kaya ko dizal mo pamatendo na tamata, ikaw na pamatendo na ikaw. Who says to you? We don't go to school to be educated. It's the Spirit of God in you will give us the basic things of God. Kona kalilu serani kalu sasuri nato mebika. Amen. Gay may muri na kena pagarara mataki. We go to Bible study and we go to school. Sa gay muri kena maya. But the basic things of God, God deliver to us through the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Mungkin saya minggu tu kan sabu kami juga. Eh sebenarnya mendengar juga muli ko sabu ku. Amen. See, our forefathers, they never go to school. Some of them from Rotuma. Eh?
They don't receive any higher education, but see the way they build their house. Can withstand cyclone. You go to Lau and they build this house that at the edge is round. It's like a rugby ball.
Hallelujah.
And because Lau sometimes is very humid, and they have these long windows. You bring the coconut leaves and then you knit it together and you cut the one in the middle, the branch that goes in the middle. So one you hang it up because you already knit it, and one will fall down. Who teach them all these things? Nasima, Bolambola, Kato Bolambola, Nayabira. Who taught them to do Nayabira? Spirit of God. Amen. It's a spirit of God. Kundi ka kaili na mayaga na tabio ka isang taong nga kita tatan na sino. They mix it in a flour, wala din na suka, ito na malam lama. Kundi ka mabuli na. It's a spirit of God.
Amen.
I tell you, if you listen, if you walk right and listen to the spirit of God, there's a lot of things that brings wisdom. It's come from God. The knowledge come from education.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Alamun era do buku kina magaliw ko rin ng kagasi. Ura buku yal matua kita buku dia dia. Amen.
Amen.
I'll share with you some example. Can I share with you some example? They don't go to school. They hardly, even for my parents, I'm speaking for my village, I'm speaking for my parents. They hardly go through class 3, class 4, class 5. They only go to school and their textbook is the Bible. Amen. And all their calculators are the stone and the tilo. Hallelujah. But you hardly see divorce. You hardly see that people having committing adultery.
Hallelujah.
But they don't attend any formal education. They don't even pass from class 8. Forget about form 4 and form 5. Universities are second to none. But see how they nurture their children. That their children hardly go to prison. Or come and do suicide in the city of Suba. Do you get what I'm saying? But now the parents of today, one can be a teacher, one can be a doctor, but after 5 years of marriage, they want to leave one another. That's why the rate of divorce is so high. The wisdom comes from the word of God. The knowledge comes from your study and the textbook that you see. Amen. Can I example of the two people? I have a bakuroi, a tapakalama. To have been 20, a revitwasing among I told you the man I see. Ah, to eat there. See, it's 10, it's 20. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Bakuroi too. Munubina dia, munubina umuru, munubina security. Satorrojiko, buku, lilia. That's why you need the word of God. It will give you the wisdom. And I tell you, some people, they sit, you see them in town, you see them in the workplace. They look nice, they are logo. Riri totokani, tutu, senga, matukwale kamoru. Okoyomu, they lost to me too. Amen. Yeah. There is no elements of God to convict, because only the word of God will convict.
Yeah.
Will judge your mind if what you're doing is wrong. Yeah. Only the Spirit of God. That's why we need to come to the presence of God all the time, so we can put ourselves in the altar, and we will know our weakness. That's why we come to the altar. And we sacrifice the part of our body that we need to be readjusted, realigned. Amen. You need to readjust, realign your life. Amen. But then you put to a tomato, last time you put to a tomato, come on to the matawali. Dina is in his own. And when I don't have any total gas in new melodies, my Ramasa. Na kanga tu mi pa na kanga ni muni wai na kanga ni kasi ni muli no na kanga na kada mama tetu koran rebe chuma lori mama tetu koran ba fe chichu gina ya ir bisum chuma mani lenda Maroma ko isa kanila galak. Ilawato, ilawato no romiso mina galak. Pero naman, nabuko yung matua, and ang control tagir na nabuko nila. Hallelujah. We need the mind of God in the leadership in Fiji. We need the mind of God to be in the leadership of Vanua. Because the people with the mind of God will tell us the things of God. Hallelujah. If not, we'll just like Egyptian. We'll be just like Babylonian. We'll be just like Persian and Medes. Or we'll be just like Rome and Italy. We run around, we look good, we sound good, but we always come to zero. Hallelujah. And look at those who trust in the Lord. We've been hearing the government, the nation of Israel, from the biblical time till today. Satu me o papiloni, kaka seri seri. Satu me o ispita, satu satu ngayon to ni mirbe. Amen. Satu me o irugura, sakita giro to no naman. Because Israel depend on the God that ever lost. That stood the trials of time. Amen. It's a big challenge. Kamu dengar dua challenge yang dia. Hallelujah. Where we should go from here? We need the mind of God into any leadership, into any nation. Because these people, they will correct. I remember when Donald Trump won, he called all the Pentecostal Taltala to pray over him, so he can make the right decision. He's a millionaire or a billionaire. And yet he called for the Taltala to pray for him, to give him wisdom and knowledge to lead the nation of the United States of America. Charito Royal. And do a something that may president. And do a billionaire. He's very smart. He takes a smart person to build up from nothing to become a billionaire or billionaire for that matter. And yet when he sit on the hot seat, the driving seat of the United States of America, he called the pastors to pray for him. Father, what can I? Big challenge. Amen. My mother said, hallelujah. What we need is the mind of God. Lord, I need your mind to be in my mind. Hallelujah. Do you want to hear what I sing there before? For those of you that are watching Facebook, those of you that are watching television, let us come and worship Him and ask the Lord, the mind of God, to become our mind. Because the mind of God has wisdom, authority, and power. Come. Believe that God will do something special. Any sickness, any loads of your life, bring it to the Lord this morning. On this wonderful afternoon, bring it to the Lord. Bring it to the Lord now. Believe that God will do something now. Believe God that will move mightily, powerfully. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. For those of you watching through the Facebook, those of you watching on the television, believe that God will do something. Register in your mind, in your heart, that God will do something. Hallelujah. Man. Lago may nabang ang bota. Lago may nabang ang inyo. Sugeti que a tatale tico nesse tio mais tumba. Romo tico que a tatale tico. Não bora, não bora, não bora. Sua beca nem fala, mas nem bula, que a tatale tico. Tico para na tome mate.
Oh, hallelujah. Lumsa, me contou o salmo, 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 me contou o